Thanks for joining us. My name's Rachel. I'm from the Innisfil Idea Lab and Library, and in today's Tinkershop tutorial, we're going to go over Inkscape 101. The topics that we're going to be covering are your document properties, object properties, so your fill and stroke and what do they mean, your cutting and engraving settings. We're going to go over all the tools. We're going to be going over the text tool and a couple of font options and putting your font onto a path, making it curved. We're going to learn a little bit about the path menu and what you can do with different shapes. We're going to also learn about importing images, trace bitmapping, and then we'll be going over our saving. So when you first open up your Inkscape program, you will notice that there is a square in the middle of your page, and this is known as your canvas. Anything that you design must be within this square of your canvas. Anything that you design outside of that, it will not be captured by the screen and it cannot be recognized. So first thing I usually do is I will set my document properties for how large I would like my object to be. Then I'm either laser engraving or laser cutting. You start by going up to the file menu and clicking on document properties. A new window will appear, and under display units, I click this drop down menu. I'll switch this to inches. And under units here, instead of millimeters, I also will turn this over to inches. Now, within the width and the height is where I put in my measurements of what I would like my object to be. And you'll see already that we have our square here. Our canvas has changed size. As a quick shortcut, you can hit your plus and minus key to zoom in and out. I'm just gonna draw an object. I'm gonna use a square here. I'm gonna click and drag. You just see a line right now. If you go underneath the object menu and click on fill and stroke, a new window will appear. You can also find this icon at the right-hand side of your screen. Now, what is fill and stroke? Well, when you click on the fill tab and hit the solid square, you'll notice now that the inside of the object has turned black and it's filled in. So the fill is the infill of a color of your object. And what a stroke is, if you remove the fill, go over to stroke paint, click the solid square, and stroke is your outer line. So the fill is your infill color and a stroke is the outline of your object.
So how do I know what to set as a cut line and what to set as an engraving? Let's do an example. I'll click on my text tool because I want this to engrave. I'm going to click anywhere on the screen and begin typing.
What I'm going to do is I would like this to be cut, and then I want my text to be engraved. Now, how do you tell the difference between that? So right now I've selected my text. I'll go over to my stroke style. There is no stroke selected. So that means that it's going to be fill only. So fill only is your engraving setting. And if I click on my outer line that I want, this is what I would like my sign to be cut out of. I don't want a fill, but I do want a stroke. And in stroke style, I have to put in a certain number. If you go under into inches and use the magic number 0.001, this will get your design to cut. I could also just cut out letters. If I remove the fill, I'm gonna go to stroke paint and add a stroke and then change the stroke style to, instead of 0.010, I'm gonna put 0.01. I've also now just told it to cut the solid square just to get everything back together. So that's a little bit about engraving and cutting. That was one of the things I struggled with when I first started learning. I had a hard time understanding the concept. Play with it, get to know it, but just remember, anytime you want something to cut, it has to go under your stroke style. You'll have to click on inches and type in 0.001. Anything else, it will engrave. Okay, so we're gonna go over our tools. Your first tool here is your move tool. And your move tool here can help you move objects, size your objects. You can click on it a second time and you can rotate your object. The next tool here is called your edit path tool. I use this usually when I'm having images imported or if I'm trying to connect certain objects.
For laser cutting and engraving, I usually stick with a few tools such as my square tool, my circle tool, my star tool.
My square tool will make squares.
By clicking and dragging, I can create squares in different shapes.
My circle tool will make circles by clicking and dragging, and you can change them. And say if you've got something distorted, just go back to your move tool, and you can kind of make it more square, or you can go up to the very top here and change your measurements as well, and it'll tell you what your measurements are. Another tool is your Bezier tool, and there's your text tool. I don't really touch any of the other items when I'm designing for the laser cutter. Just those are pretty much the main tools we go over.
There's quite a few features that you can do with using the text tool. So by creating a text, you can change its font.
You can also change the font by either going up to your font styles and when you're in your text tool. Or you can click the T on the side here and a window will pop up and you'll be able to see a preview of your text. And then when within this box, you can actually scroll through and see different font styles. And say you found one that you like, just click the apply button. This should automatically change your text. A trick is, say you wanted your text to be curved. Now you can do that. You're gonna have to use your circle tool. Create a circle. Go back to your move tool. Hold down shift and click your text. And then when you go up to the text menu, click put on path. You can move your text and you can rotate your text wherever you would like it to be. The only thing is, now your square circle will not be captured because it's off the canvas page. But if you click your circle, you can adjust then what your text is gonna look like. You can make it bigger, smaller, more curved. But anything you do and move around the circle, it will control your text. But if you go back to your text, you can move it anywhere and it won't move the circle. A little confusing, but that's one way you can get curved text. Next, we're going to show a couple of features that you can actually create your own shapes with. So I'm going to use my circle tool here. And I'm going to create a couple of more circles and I'm going to have them overlap and I'm going to change the color when I do this. Now, when I've got my fill down here, you can actually select colors from the color bar down below. And I'm just going to do this so we can see it a little bit better. Next, I'm going to draw a square around all three of my objects to know that they're selected. And under the path menu, you actually have some neat features. You can click union and they all become one object then. So you can make clouds this way. I'm going to hit Control Z to undo. If I select one and hold down shift and select another one, just the two, I can go under the path menu and click difference and it will cut away an object. I'm going to select these two objects and I'm going to go underneath the path menu and click intersection. And then it only captures the one shape that's kind of overlapping between them. I'm going to select again two objects. Let's try three objects, path menu, we're going to do exclusion. Now exclusion kind of makes all these different things. And then if you wanted, you could go up to the path menu and click break apart and they all should become different shapes. Those are a few options underneath the path menu. You also have an option that's called break apart. So say you have combined all of your items, we're going to combine together and then click path and break them apart.
And they're all broken apart at this point. That's just another couple of options underneath the path menu.
You can also do this with text. You can turn them into objects. So if I click on the text tool, click on my page, I can go back up to my move tool. I can go to path and click on object to path. This now makes it my text an object, but now they all have objects and I can control what these will look like now. Pretty neat. Next, we're gonna import images. So when you're looking for images, it's important that you look for black and white images, vectors, silhouettes. So we're gonna go to Google or any kind of web browser that you have, and we're going to select it. We're going to look for an image. So I'm going to type in dogs, but I want black and white. So you can go to image. Now, some of these are really great. If you want them to be engraved, these are ideal images. We'll use this one right now. It's a nice silhouette. I found an image. I clicked on it. I'm going to right click on top of it and hit save image as. just going to save it to the desktop. And then I'm going to go back to my Inkscape program. Next, I'm going to have to import my image. So I'm going to go up to File, Import. I'm going to go look and find my image. Click on it and hit Open. I'm going to click OK. And you can see right now, this is my image. Now I'm just going to remove some of these windows so we can see a little bit better. So now I want to turn it into what's called a vector image. How do I do that? I'm going to go up to the Path menu and click the third option down called Trace Bitmap. Sometimes it gets tucked away in your toolbar here to the right-hand side, so click on that tab. My image is selected. I'm going to click Update. And I'm going to click OK. And now you can see we have two images. It has a transparent background and the other one doesn't. The one that doesn't have a transparent background, we can actually remove it. This image here, how do you tell if it's ready to engrave or if it's ready to cut? Well, you can do either. You can click on your Fill and Stroke tab. You can click the Fill tab. And right now we see it has a fill, but it does not have a stroke. So it is set to engrave, but if say you wanted this to be cut out instead of engrave, you can still do that with an image. You can click on File, hit X, click on the Stroke Paint tab, click the solid square, and now you have an outline, just the stroke. And then you can change that to, what's that magic number again? 0.001. Click Enter, and now it's ready to cut. I can make this a little bit bigger. Looking up at the top, right now it's telling me that it's about almost 3.5 inches by 2.5 inches high. I could add text to this as well. So I could click and place that anywhere. And if I wanted to, I could actually even put a couple of little holes here and here. And that is exactly where the laser cutter will cut out. So any of that stroke there is exactly where the laser will cut out. Object. Now there's a couple of other fun features too that you can use. Now if you're doing multiples of a certain sign, you can click and drag around your objects here and you can move them around, but as soon as you click away and try to move something, you're only selecting that one. So that's because we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 objects. So if you draw a box around that and you want to move them but keep them together, highlight them all. Go up to the object menu and click group. And now you can move your object as one. If you right click, you can hit duplicate and you can make copies. And this will save all the settings that you already have for cutting and engraving. Now for saving, we're gonna go up to File, Save As. Now this is important. We need to usually save both files. So we're going to save an SVG and we are going to also save what's called a PDF. And then we're going to go up to File, Save As again, but instead we're going to go into this drop-down menu here, click it, and select PDF, Portable Document Format. Click Save and click OK.
And that's Inkscape 101. Thank you for joining me and have yourself a wonderful day.